This is Coffee Break with Ninita, a daily guide of coping skills that gets us through by making us strong. Whatever happened, how did you and I, that were so loving, and when we were discussing opinions, we were finding a way to agree, and sometimes we were agreeing to disagree. Our relationship was so beautiful, so close, we were so connected. And now, we don't want to talk to each other, because if we talk, we might end up arguing. We are arguing so much, and before, we used to agree in everything. How can this happen? Usually, when we meet for the first time, there's no frame of reference. So we create the frame of reference we place that person in. And depending on how we feel, how much we like that person, what that person fulfills in our lives, depending on that frame of reference, we become more flexible with the differences, we become more tolerant with the things that we cannot stand. Ironically, a lot of times what we value in people is exactly what, as we get to know them more, we cannot stand. And this happens because in the beginning of a relationship, because we want to connect, we get very, very effective in molding our opinions and paying attention in not causing the other person to become hard. We put the effort because there's no relationship yet established. You know, it is like taking two parts that we want to glue together. We put the glue and we hold it tight until the glue dries. And then it is glued together. We do the same thing in relationships. We hold each other tight emotionally because we want to stay together, to be with that person. And once this is accomplished and it is achieved, then we let go. We let go of that effort of making sure we are connected emotionally, mentally, physically. I said make sure, meaning that we still want that attention, affection, and appreciation coming to us from the other person. But we don't really put the effort in giving it back in the way we want them to give it to us. We sort of get very relaxed and comfortable that by the other person giving us the attention, affection, appreciation, we're worth it. And if we're worth it, why bother put effort, right? If we are worth it, we start getting lazy because we feel that the other person has that kind of attraction just by us being us. But this is not so. The beauty in us comes forward when we reach out the other person and give attention and appreciation. And unless it is reciprocated, this relationship soon is going to get unglued, soon is going to fall apart. You hear people saying, I don't know what happened, but we fell out of love. And what that means is we got very comfortable. We stopped putting the effort of caring in our behaviors. Sometimes, we have said that before, we underestimate the power behaviors hold in bridging and connecting the two different worlds that the two people involved have grown. And a lot of times, there are, like we call, old tapes. There are old life experiences that interfere with the connection when we don't have each other's behavior to anchor to. If I say, I love you, why do I have to tell you or show you that I love you all the time? You should know that I love you. I'm not only hurting the other person by not getting the behavior from me that shows that I love them, but at the same time, that behavior that I stop using or showing harms me the same way. Remember what I have said. We cannot control thoughts and feelings, but we can control behaviors. And the behaviors have the power to influence how we feel about people. So when I don't maintain and sustain my loving, caring, compassionate behavior to the people in my world, eventually I develop an I don't care attitude. I feel that the other person has stopped fulfilling me. And it is nothing that the other person has done that caused this damage, that break, as much as my very own behavior. It is my very own behavior that stops fulfilling me. It is my very own behavior that causes me to lose interest in the other person. So no matter how much the other person loves me and cares for me and fulfills me, if I don't express that behavior of reciprocity, if I don't show exactly in my behavior how I feel towards them, the relationship is going to get unglued, because it takes both people's behavior for the relationship to stay whole. Please leave your comments and suggestions on Facebook or email us on stayhall@gmail.com. Until tomorrow, stay well and God bless you.